For centuries, the Bible was inaccessible to most English-speaking Christians for a variety of reasons, not the least of which was that all but the educated classes were totally illiterate. Even those who could read would still have a hard time getting their hands on one. Though, prior to the invention of the printing press, they were painstakingly copied by hand and would have been rare and invaluable. And then there was the fact that the Bible was written in languages that you'd have to study for years to understand. It wasn't actually translated into English until the 1300s.
Romanes eunt domus. People call Romanes, they go the house.
It says Romans go home.
No, it doesn't.
In 1611, the big daddy of English translations of the Bible came into being, the King James Bible, translated from various texts into English on orders of King James I. To this day, 4 centuries after its initial publication, not only is it still printed, but the text still permeates the English lexicon. This is the text from which iconic phrases such as "do unto others" and "thou shalt not kill" first appear. These days, there are dozens of Bible translations available to English-speaking Christians, but for a small subset of Christians, the King James Version is the only way to go. Indeed, some Christians lean so heavily into the KJV that they believe that any other English translation of the text is flawed to the point of being heretical. So what's the reasoning behind this belief?
Vocative plural of Annus is...
Annie?
Romani?
To understand the King James only controversy, you first got to understand the history of the Bible itself. To make an extremely long story short, the original pages on which the original authors wrote their words are long gone. The copies of those manuscripts form the basis for the current Bible. The King James Version was translated from one set of manuscripts, while other English translations come from a different set of manuscripts. On his blog The Gospel Coalition, the columnist and author Trevin Wax writes, "The King James only controversy is essentially a conspiracy theory that claims that all modern translations of scripture are based on tainted manuscripts, and that their translators are driven by a liberal Protestant or Roman Catholic agenda." However, KJV-only adherent Ken Matto, writing in Scion of Zion, explains why he doesn't see things that way. He points to several specific Bible verses, and the differences in translation therein, as evidence that modern translations completely mess up the meaning of the text. In fact, he believes these botched translations promote a heretical doctrine. Matto writes, "The serious challenges the church faces today is due to the influx of counterfeit Bible versions."
Go home, this is motion to wars, isn't it, boy?
The debate stems from the different ways that some versions of the Bible are translated. Some take an approach called meaning to meaning. These versions are close to the original text, but use more modern language. A contrasting kind of translation of the Bible is largely done by paraphrasing, using freer or looser translations. There are other arguments that King James Version only adherents might make, most of which involve other arcane textual issues. However, beneath all these obscure complexities, one simple fact is that many Christians choose the KJV for no other reason than that they like it. Writing for his blog Head, Heart and Hand, theology professor David Murray notes that many Christians grew up in congregations that use the KJV in teaching and preaching, and they feel there's no need to buck tradition. To them, familiarity is comfortable. Murray writes, "The language is part of their spiritual vocabulary and reminds them of many sermons they heard throughout the years." Similarly, in the minds of some believers, there may exist a us versus them mentality. Notably, some Christians brought up in the KJV tradition believe that churches that use more modern English translations are rejecting old doctrine. As well as that, more modern translations are filled with footnotes that point readers to textual variances, contextual clues, and other similar details. These footnotes distract and confuse some readers and push them toward the KJV. Between that and the familiarity of a tried and tested translation, it's no surprise that the King James Version of the Bible continues to stand the test of time. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more grunge videos about religious history are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.